మహబూబ్ నగర్ జిల్లా పాలమూరు యూనివర్సిటీలో 2వ స్నాతకోత్సవాలు ఘనంగా జరిగాయి. మద్రాస్ యూనివర్సిటీ మాజీ ఉపకులపతి త్యాగరాజన్ ముఖ్య అతిథిగా విచ్చేశారు. ఈ సందర్భంగా పాలమూరు యూనివర్సిటీ ఉపకులపతి రాజారత్నం మాట్లాడుతూ, పాలమూరు యూనివర్సిటీ స్థాపించి దాదాపు 10 సంవత్సరాలు కావస్తున్నదని, ఈ యూనివర్సిటీలో చదువుకున్న విద్యార్థులు మంచి స్థాయిలో ఉన్నారని అన్నారు. సైన్స్ విభాగంలో దాదాపు 1475 మంది పీజీ టాప్ ర్యాంకులో పాస్ అయిన విద్యార్థులు త్యాగరాజన్ చేతుల మీదుగా మెడల్స్ అందుకున్నారు.
Distinguished guests, faculty, staff members, graduating students, media friends, ladies and gentlemen, I have great pleasure in welcoming you all the second convocation of Palmer University this afternoon. At the very outset, I on behalf of Palamuru University and my personal behalf extend a warm welcome to our distinguished chief guest Professor SP Tyagarajan garu. Sir, we deem it an honor to have you with us on this auspicious occasion. I congratulate all the students who are here to receive the gold medals and degrees. I wish them all a very bright future and a prosperous career. I take this opportunity to mention that the first convocation of the university was held on 29th November 2014, where in Professor A.N. Roy, the then director NAC Bangalore, was the chief guest. In all, 7,636 UG and PG degrees were awarded and 60 gold medals were presented at this inaugural convocation. Palamur University has made much the headway during the very first decade of its establishment. Ours is a state university set up through statutory enactment in the year 2008 to expand the avenues of higher education in the predominantly backward and tribal areas of Mahbub Nagar and adjoining district in Telangana. In emanating from the erstwhile postgraduate college of Usmania University at Mahbub Nagar, as the nucleus, we have set out with a vision and a plan of action. On the academic front, new courses, both regular and self-financing, were started. All side premise was accorded to infrastructure development for creation of academic facilities and student amenities in the sphere of structural expansion. Equal attention was paid to the nurturing of 3 constant PG centers which have come under the fold of this developing university. In turn with this, its mission, Palamur University has been adding new and needed need-based courses from time to time to cater to the emerging requirements. By 2014 and 15, the university was offering 19 academic programs at its 3 campus colleges and 3 constant PG centers put together here. In line with the blueprint, the university embarked upon the construction of administrative block, academic block, then pharmacy block, ground floor, library building, and a girls' hostel, along with the expansion of existing boys' hostel and university PG college building at a cost of this momentous moment. I have the honor to present a brief report on the activities and achievements of the university during the period December 2014 to date on this occasion. Palamuru University is in forefront in initiating academic reforms and innovations such as semester system and choice-based credit system at both PG and UG levels. While CBCS was introduced in PG courses during 2013 and 14, the university followed up the policy directive of Telangana State Council for Higher Education in launching CBCS at UG level during 2016 and 17. In doing so, it conducted preparatory workshops, orientation programs for the concerned functionaries and faculty from affiliated colleges. Palamuru University is an affiliating university with a diverse profile of 151 colleges under its jurisdiction. These comprise 96 under graduation colleges, 13 post-graduation colleges, and 42 professional colleges with a student strength of 48,420. Affiliated colleges constitute the varied academic landscape of the university. The university acquired primacy to institutional framework of evaluation and academic audit for maintenance of higher standards in higher education. The quality initiatives taken up by the university include drawing up the common academic calendar, provision of biometric attendance and installation of CC cameras at campus and constant colleges. This has been made mandatory for all the affiliated colleges for grant of annual affiliation. During the period under review, apart from offering MCOM, the new course of MSc Computer has been started at PG Center Gadwal as part of strengthening the institution. A major breakthrough in the academic diversification of Palamuru University is the introduction of doctoral programs in 5 selected disciplines during 2017 and 18. This will give a big push to the research pursuits in the coming years. Admissions to PhD have been made as per UGC 2016 regulations. 226 research scholars have been enrolled in the Department of Chemistry, Commerce and Business Management, English, Microbiology and Physics put together. Conduct of seminars, conferences for dissemination of knowledge and experience sharing is a regular feature at Palamuru University. During the period under review, 32 seminars, conferences were held. Special reference needs to made to the International Conference on Chemistry for Sustainable Future held during 7th to 9th August 2018. The university has the fine tradition of organizing faculty development programs for updating the knowledge and teaching skills of faculty. International collaborations find a meaningful experience in these academic events. These include faculty development program on gender sensitization from 23rd June 2015 to 36th 2015 in collaboration with Telangana State Council for Higher Education. Faculty development program on pedagogy from 17th June 2016 to 36th 2016 in collaboration with the Telangana State Council for Higher Education. faculty development program in chemistry from 18 June 2018 to 23rd June 2018. Having about 151 affiliated colleges besides three PG centers with a student strength of about 48,420. To manage this much of students by a university which is so young is really marvelous. My appreciation to all. The other unique feature is that the main campus itself is offering about 19 academic programs, including the PhD programs, with a total of 1,293 students as of 2017-18. And from the Vice Chancellor's detailed report provided to you in a great kind of impressive manner, I could really extract out certain very unique achievements that the university has made. First of all, making a university green in an area which is drought prone has to be appreciated and recorded. Secondly, there are a lot of new universities coming up which are not able to get the UGC recognition for funding, and this university has got the recognition under Section 12B of the UGC Act and dedication of the Vice Chancellor. And what is most important, the university is doing well. That is the inference that we can easily get. Getting hostels for girls and boys of the people who are coming from distant places here and providing accommodation to almost 85 to 90% of the students to a tune of 900 is another appreciable factor in this particular university. As university progresses, a quality benchmarking becomes necessary, and that is where this university has made its attempts very meticulously by establishing an internal quality assurance cell and also going through the NAC accreditation process boldly to see that they are able to get the quality benchmarking done. I can go on saying like this, like for example, getting several, even as a young university, able to get a research grant of about 2 crores through several projects by the departments, filing some 5 patents and getting some state honors and awards is definitely indicative of your commitment and your dedication, which is specificated not only by the graduates and students, but also by the dedicated faculty members and teachers. For this, I wholeheartedly congratulate all those who are responsible for it. And today is the graduation or the convocation day. I congratulate all the graduate students who have received their degrees just now and awards in this convocation. As privileged students of this prestigious university, the knowledge and skill that you all have gained here will ensure you to become successful citizens of the country. My hearty congratulations once again to all of you and best wishes to all of you. I think in this context of convocation, the chief guest always shares some of the thoughts which may be useful to you, not only at the present point of time and also in a futuristic approach to the university itself. So I would like to only tell you what the 21st century expects out of you. The 21st century expects from all of you a host of potentials and capabilities. But today's youth have lot of multiple pressures, like peer pressure is there, parental pressure is there, educational pressure is there, and above all, employability pressure is there. You have to really get yourself profitably employed, for which certain necessary skills have been set. If you look into the reality of situation across the world, as per the data provided by the United Nations National Policy Action on Youth Employment, it has outlined that there are certain priorities for the 21st century on employability. Based on this policy framework, the International Youth Employment Network suggested to all the countries to rethink and reorient education vocational training and also labor market policies along with the employability skills which are specially required for the employability of the graduates. Because under the of the skill that is there which is needed for the job market, and that is where you can improve the or increase the employability skills. But still the reports say that in India about 50-70% of them either unemployed or underemployed, not up to their qualification. That is the reality of the situation across all the disciplines in higher education. Today you can see unemployability even among medical graduates and dental graduates, and that is the kind of the situation. So what is the compounding factor? If you look at it, there has been an impact of employment market by a phenomenon called Industry 4.0. What is this Industry 4.0? It is given to the current trend of automation and data exchange in all service and manufacturing sectors. It includes cyber physical systems, Internet of Things called IoT, cognitive computing or artificial intelligence called AI, cloud computing and data analytics, etc. You may think that I am talking about engineering and technology, but the fact is technology synergy is required with each and every discipline of higher education, ranging from arts, humanities, languages, social sciences, engineering and technology, and professional disciplines like medical, veterinary, and agricultural sciences. That is why it has become Industry 4.0 phenomenon, which will have high impact today on the employability of graduates from whatever discipline the students are going to get graduated. So this kind of a fourth industrial revolution, it warrants and demands education also to go through a 4.0 revolution. And this is being proactively promoted by the 21st century higher education system. So in view of this kind of a above mentioned events that have taken place, youth education requires upgrading of relevant domain knowledge through synergy of arts, humanities, science and technology, and other advanced areas of Industry 4.0, and inculcation of certain employability skills along with their degrees. Just degrees alone is not able to provide them employability potentials. So what are these employability potentials? They are cognitive skills, people related interpersonal skills, teamwork and leadership skills, conceptualizing and analytical thinking skills, business skills, effective communication skills, and innovative idea generation skills. These are the kind of skills that are to be parallelly inculcated among the daily going students. There is an international level definition for employability which states, I quote, a set of skills, knowledge, and personal attributes that make an individual more likely to secure and be successful in the chosen occupation to the benefit of themselves, the workforce, the country, and the economy. I unquote. This definition is actually reasonable, but it does raise certain questions about the nature of the personal attributes that are indicated. What are personal attributes? The personal attributes are a wide category and suggest an additional ingredient relying on personality development of the graduating youth. The question often raised is whether higher education system or the higher learning induces acquisition of knowledge, skills, attributes, and innovative ideas. So we have to accept that currently available curricula and the pedagogy and the teaching learning methods that are adopted are not able to provide this personal attribute put together.